BakerStreet.coasters live. So today I'm literally whizzing through my top 25 roller coasters. Because you know I did this earlier, now I'm going to do this now. Right, so top 25 roller coasters of the 2024 season. Now, starting at number 25, I have Rita because absolutely appalling ride. Don't like this ride. No. Number 24, we then have Accelerator because Accelerator at Drayton Manor, absolutely amazing ride. I love it to pieces. I loved it when it was Ben 10. Theming of it now is a bit, it's a garage. 23, it's quite smooth as well, Accelerator. 23, we have Runaway Mine Train because, you know, Runaway Mine Train is one of those rides which it's good, it's amazing, I love the theme into it, it has some really good interactions with Congo River Rapids, but at the same time, it. Number 22, we then have Rattlesnake. Now, Rattlesnake at Chessington Wild Adventures is alright. It has some really good theming, bit rough here and there, but it really does make a good and unique mouse trap ride. 21, we then have Rattlesnake at, now this Rattlesnake was at Gulliver's, and it was an amazing ride. I absolutely adored the ride. It's no longer there, I think it's back open now, but back in 2014-11 I went in it, and it was just, yeah. Then Enigma, also at Gulliver's, which again, a good ride. Absolutely love the twists and turns of this ride. I am really sad that this ride's gone. Blue Flyer, Blue Flyer is number 19. And it was at, I don't know if it's still there, but it was in front of Nickelodeon Streak at Blackpool Pleasure Beach. It was an amazing wooden roller coaster. But yet again, don't know if it's still there. Talking about wooden roller coasters, Warsaw and Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Number 18, we have Nickelodeon Streak. Love the ride. Could have some more theming, as it is something to do with Nickelodeon. It's got really bright orange to it. Repaint, definite. Or just get rid of your wooden roller coasters because, you know, yeah. Then number 17, we go to Legoland. We have the Dragon's Apprentice because Dragon's Apprentice, good family ride. I was denied getting on it last time because, you know, I was too tall and I was like, really? But yeah, really good ride, really tells a story compared to the bigger dragon. So you've got like smaller and then you've got bigger. Number 16, Scorpion Express, hasn't been open quite a while. Put that top though. I do put that top above Runaway Mine Train. Number 15, we've got the Dragon at Legoland. Amazing ride, really good storyline. Could have beat it. It's the only unique storyline. In the world, in the UK, because, you know, it's got a dark ride, it's got Lego and animatronics in there, it's amazing. Number 14, Antelope at Gulliver's, another good one. It's a good wooden roller coaster, quite slow, but the airtime's pretty good. 13, we have Great Yarmouth roller coaster, which is also another wooden roller coaster. It doesn't need theming as you go with the chain lift, you've literally got this theming of the beach. I mean, who doesn't love watching the beach? And the whole scenery is literally just a beach. Number 12, we have Vampire at Chessington Royal Adventures. Really rough ride, really controversial, but I wouldn't say it's top. It really does need a retrack, even though it's like 34 years old or something like that. Mandrill Mayhem is number 11. Really good ride. I adore it with a passion. I love the inversion. I love how Chessington, they've invested into a ride like this. Jumanji theming to it is quite good. This isn't a jewel, this is a mandrill. And it really has some really good themes around the area as well, as we've got Jumanji in the board game kind of thing. It's deal with the like you've got Vampire, you've got Bats, Gruffalo. It deals with the animal side of things and the theming. Number 10 now. Walking Dead the ride. Amazing ride. Really good theming. Love the pre-show at the start. If you do get it, then you're lucky. At Fort Park, of course. And it's a really big step up from X No Way Out. Not in number 9, we have Stealth. Yet again, it is the better hydraulic launch coaster out of Rita. Really fast, really is up to the speed it says. And you can't go wrong with it, really, unless you get a rollback, and it would be really cool if you do get a rollback. But number 8, we have Galactica. Quite low from last year's results. Galactica is one of those things which, it's okay, a bit rough here and there, a little bit more rough than last year. But it needs a TLC to, well, it's had some TLC, it's had some new lighting, but the TLC could be better to it. And the phalanx, if it was a phalanx theming, it would be really cool. That whole area would be complete with it. Number 7, got the Smiler, really rough ride. I despise this ride with a passion sometimes. Even though the latest ride was quite smooth, but at the same time, it was really rough on that Heartland roll. Just now. Number six, Flying Scotsman at Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Absolute amazing and stunner of a ride. It's really good to see you've got no track, because, you know, having no track brings in more of the fearless side, and you're quite above everywhere else as well. Number five, 13 at Alton Towers. Good ride, only it's the unique because it drops down, it goes backwards, and the only quickest part is when it goes back into the station, but it's got to be better than Smiler because, well, it's 13 and I've grew up with that ride all my life. At number four, we then have The Swarm, because The Swarm was my top like quite a few years ago. Swarm, amazing ride. Love how it's got real theming in it. The aspects, the helicopter side of it is amazing. I just love the theming around, you know, and the whole ride's smooth and you can't fault it, especially when it's a ring coaster. It's a full circuit ring coaster. Wicker Man is number two. Now, it was top one last year. Wicker Man is number two. It is probably the most, well, it is probably the best wooden roller coaster out there. Oh, it is in my eyes. Pyrotechnics is amazing, has some really good theming around the queue, has the soundtrack which gets darker as you go around the queue, as you get further into the queue, but has some really bad downtime, which is why I put number one as Nemesis Reborn, because it has a lack of that downtime. I've been in it like four times now. It's so much better than the original. More G-forces, comes off dizzy if you don't eat properly. And it'll still get an adding to it, adds to the area of the Phalanx facility and Forbidden Valley. It goes with everything which has been put into that area. It's just amazing, and you know, I can't falter Nemesis Reborn whatsoever. So tell me what you guys think of my top 25 roller coasters in the UK of 2024, and please remember to subscribe. Smile always.